Okie dokie. Thanks for showing up or for staying for my talk. Scratching an itch by patching kmscon, or put in other words, how knowing OpenGL can actually lead to systems programming, believe it or not. Before I continue, I want to set the stage. I see this talk as a partly being an experience report by somebody who did a drive-by contribution to kmscon. Well, yeah, that's me. And also to some degree, call for help with testing and maybe poking upstream to review my pull requests. And on top of all that, the whole thing is running on kmscon, the patched version. So it's now a graphical output, and it's basically one big live demo. So fingers crossed, nothing goes wrong. Here, there's a quick overview of what I'm going to be talking about in the next 20, 25 minutes. And so what is kmscon, for those who don't know? It is a systems console replacement meant to completely live in user space. It has a nice plugin architecture. It uses these plugin architectures for actually implementing all its major features as shared library objects. It is Unicode capable, meaning it has Cyrillic support, Korean, Farsi, no emojis. But if you are bored and would like to contribute, I guess there might be five persons on this planet who would really welcome that. Two plugins I want to point out. One is the free type font support, which means you have vector-based fonts, open type, free type. The other one, the most important one to me, is the rendering backend being based on OpenGL ES, which actually allowed the stuff to be done to it that I wanted it to do to scratch my itch. It's kind of old. It was started 2012 by David Hellman, who wanted to basically replace the in-kernel system console that's hiding behind config underscore YT. And it has a side of project where David extracted the whole kernel handling, terminal handling stuff in its separate library. It's basically, this libtsm is a toolkit neutral version of the libvte that you might be knowing from GDK or, well, GNOME. It was developed by David until about 2014, and then he magically probably vanished somewhere in the depths of Red Hat. He didn't update his branch anymore, and then from that point on, it kind of organically grew maintainership to some other place, which is there on GitHub, AETF. That's the current most active fork of kmscon. So, who am I? Usually, when I do these talks, I just say, hey, I'm XLO, I love computer graphics. Considering the circumstances, the venue, a little bit more context is in order, I think. I used to be a bit more visible and active in the open source community back in the day. I write CairoClock, CairoDoc, I worked at Canonical, I implemented Notify OSD, and I always messed around with computer graphics. And you can contact me or ask questions if you don't get them in today, later by email, the Mastodon thing, or on Twitter. And when I'm not hacking on computer graphic stuff, I like to race my motorcycles and skateboard. Enough about me. Motivation, why I'm standing here. Why did I do what I did to kmscon? I have a kind of unusual monitor setup for a regular user, maybe not so unusual for a developer. I've got two 24-inch widescreen monitors turned sideways next to each other in portrait mode. That's not much an issue if you're running KDE or GNOME, because they can easily rotate the output. When you have these moments where you don't want to be distracted by anything, you switch off every graphical output and just go to the systems console. That, with a normal system console, doesn't work very well. You see that in the picture in the corner. You sit there like that, and after a minute, you go like, fuck me. So I thought, I can't be the only person on the planet who has this problem or use case. There's got to be something that solves my issue. I looked around. I couldn't find anything. So, crap. During my research, I stumbled across kmscon. I said, ah, kmscon, that sounds interesting, intriguing. It's open source, oh, that's a good start. It has a pluggable rendering infrastructure, and one of them is OpenGL. I know OpenGL. Rotating the output by 90 degrees with OpenGL, that's a piece of cake. I'll do that in an evening, maybe a weekend, best. Famous last words, it took me maybe 1.5 weeks of some evenings. But that was last year, end of January, start of February, and I got it working. I said, oh, awesome, that's a good topic for a lightning talk at FOSDEM. Wrote the folks, I mean, 2 or 3 days before February, I have a great idea for a lightning talk. I said, no, sorry, Mirko, nice idea, but everything's taken next year. So here we are. Okay, so patch number one, the main itch to scratch. The OpenGL rendering backend that I touched, I didn't touch the rendering backends like Pixman, because, yeah, it technically would work, but it's not so nice, it's not so fast. I extended that with 2 entries in its vtable for all the methods that this plugin provides. And one of them is the gltextrotate that allows, that allows to recalculate the aspect ratio depending on the orientation that you want. And then it also recalculates the amount of columns and rows for the characters to fill the screen. And it does all that dynamically. Dynamically because of the third patch that I'll be talking about, but you'll see. And of course, talk is cheap. Let's do some more demos. I switch to another session, log in again. Tmux, so I'll create 2 paints and make something happening in these paints. Just as a stand-in, so there's stuff happening. And now I have a pre-configured hotkey with this super plus, and I'll rotate the output. This might make sense with this, but imagine your thing is turned around, right? So clockwise, counterclockwise. You can, of course, while you're doing that, resize the characters, bigger, keep rotating stuff. And make it smaller again. Oops. Okay, sounds good. Okie dokie. Come on. So much for the output rotation. That was the main itch to scratch. Then I thought, well, okay, now I spent the time to learn the code base, its architecture, how stuff works. I also really like this GPM tool. If you maybe know, GPM is this general pointer mouse daemon thing. With the old console, it provides a text cursor, which is attached to your mouse, and then you can just select text and copy and paste stuff when you're really too lazy to type. That doesn't work with kmscon. I thought, oh, fuck, I really like that. It cannot be that hard, right? So I went, okay, read the code again, and then since kmscon tries to keep its dependency over external libraries really, really slow, low, it implements its own event loop and timer system. So you read up that. It's kind of documented in the code, but not like properly. But yeah. So I figured it out. I'm using the kernel input subsystem for mice and basically implemented a new additional plugin. Right now, I still compile it directly into the binary because I'm a bit lazy, but that needs to be extracted in its own shared library. So it basically works then with mouse track points, the Bluetooth-based Apple Magic mousepad, maybe also with the first touch point for touchscreens, but I don't have that hardware. So if anybody has that hardware, please download it, report to me. I'll try to make it work if it doesn't. There's still this busy polling issue. I didn't hook that up to the event loop and the timer, so that's something I need to clean up. And the mouse plugin is also the one that actually uses the TSM directly, because the cut and paste is basically implemented in libTSM. So it allows you to select, oh, this is the start of the selection, there's the end, copy it to a clipboard buffer, which TSM handles. You don't have to deal with that in your own application code. And then you just paste it wherever the cursor ends up being. And we can demo that too. So let's cut and paste some file names. Okay. Okie dokie, here's the mouse pointer, so I can just... I think I found a new bug. That is interesting. That usually, that should not happen at that spot, but yeah. Pasting does work, so I move it up to the pane above. The problem is I'm missing some recalculation when I resize the font. So usually if I would scale it down one more, then it should work again. But that works with regular Latin text, but I mean, that's cheap. kmscon supports Unicode. So let's look for something. Oh, that's, I think that's Greek. Yeah, I think that's Greek. You select it the same way. Yeah, okay. Imagine that would be the correct. The correct. So it works there. I have no idea what type of language that is. So yeah, and yeah, it's Unicode, but it feels like a regular character, and it just works. That's the magic of kmscon. I really love it. I don't know why it's not shipped by default for every distribution. I don't know. It's really awesome. So that is patch number two. The third patch is to make it a little bit more consistent with the way stuff works in a typical desktop environment, a graphical environment. I know from GNOME, when you have a gyro sensor in the system and you turn on the laptop, it recognizes that, and then it turns, if you allow it to be turned automatically, it turns your display. And I thought, well, if you have the sensor, well, if the graphical environment, GNOME KDE, can read that, then, well, the system console should too, right? I mean, be consistent. So I sat down and looked around and implemented that. That was a bit more tricky. It was not that much work, but it was a little bit tricky. And I thought to myself, well, since the amount of external dependencies needs to be really low, I better stick with the lowest level I can get along with, and that is the low-level Dbus API, which even the Dbus maintainers discourage you from using. I used it anyway. It works. I cannot show it on this laptop. I have another laptop with me, which has such a gyro sensor. After the talk, either here or in the hallway, if you want to see that live, come by, run into me, and I'll demo that. It's really fancy. It's like extra lead points for awesomeness when you show that to your geek friends. And then at the end, there will be links to screencasts where I show that for anybody who's not here or sees that as a recording in the future. Or just download the code, compile it, and use it yourself. So the last patch, that's basically just messing around. The first three patches kind of make sense. They improve existing functionality or add new functionality. Since I'm a computer graphics nut and I like to mess around with stuff, I thought now I'll want to have fun. The best thing you can do with just a terminal-based text interface usually is, well, ASCII art. And there's this famous demo, I think everybody knows that, this ASCII art stuff. It's basically a very clever way of doing very, very low resolution ray tracing on the CPU and then using the characters as the, let's say, brightness pixels, and then this creates the illusion of a 3D object running around. But we have kmscon, and we have OpenGL rendering backend. Surely we can do better these days. And so I did. So I'll give you live GL, SL, shader backgrounds. This is a little bit my, I'm also a little bit active in the demo scene. I like to mess around on some demo events, and this type of sine distance fields rendering is typically the stuff that you do. So you have now live shader backgrounds. And this actually, although taken to the next level, also implements an old initial to-do item from David Herrmann, because he wanted to have background images. Okay, it's animated. It's real time. Oof, good, okay. Yeah. Okay, now, after all this, to upstream or not to upstream? Of course, to upstream, right? I mean, be a good open source citizen, upstream your work, You found something that you like, you improved it a little bit to scratch your itch. You put in the work to make it as clean as possible, fit with the coding style and the system software design and everything. Okay, so initially I brought my patches against the branch from David. Then I was contacted by a Debian maintainer, developer, Victor Westerhuis or something, Vicky. And he said, no, don't do that. Use this fork here from somebody else. This is much more actively maintained. It has also a Mason build system. It's much nicer. Then the likelihood of your stuff being reviewed and actually moved upstream are much greater. I did that too. And then it sits there since about 6 months ago, and not anybody looked at it and touched it. I got two requests or questions on GitHub issues. Yeah, it's just sitting there. Yeah. So this is also my hope to, let's say, mobilize the community. Say, if you really like that, if you use kmscon, if you like these features, please poke them so they review my stuff. I'm willing to put in the work to make it fit their coding style and everything as much as possible. And I've still got future ideas with truly multi-hat capable kmscon, so it's not just mirroring the stuff, so I'm seeing the same here and here, but having actually per screen connected display one terminal session with kmscon. And then, of course, you need the information of how are the screens arranged. You could gather that information from any settings saved from KDE or GNOME. To read that with kmscon, you need the libraries from KDE or GNOME to link. That's not so nice. Nicer would be kind of an ncurses interface where you have then ASCII art graphics to arrange your layout of your screens. But I started actually doing that. It's not finished yet, but it would be really nice, and maybe it would be accepted upstream too. So links to the source code, some blog posts where talked about what worked, what didn't work, what was hard, some small milestones, lots of screencasts where I tried to spread the word a little bit, but the thing like and subscribe doesn't work because nobody's watching my stuff, so I put it there anyway. Yeah. Are there any questions? And yeah. Go.
So, two small ones, I guess, with the mouse support.
Yes.
Were you actually trying to double click?
Yes. So the question is to select double click. Yes, that does work. I implemented that, but it's a bit iffy. But usually it works. But there's some kings I still need to iron out. But yes, yeah, that works.
And is Maxwell your single handle?
Yes, basically that is my nickname forever and ever. I always use, and it's not a pun on Apple systems. It's just Maxwell. It's yeah. That is my C handle. No, I'm a single person. I know the demo scene from forever, but I only got active about 3-4 years ago, and I'm not part of a demo group. I ran two times at Revision and Evoke into the folks from Logicoma. I'm kind of sometimes jumping on the stream from Hoffman. He's basically doing Amiga assembler stuff, and he's an awesome musician. But I'm not part of a demo group. But I love the demo scene. I mean, if you like computer graphics and you don't own the demo scene, you're seriously missing out.
Come to some parties in Sweden.
Yeah, I know. There's the gathering, assembly, and all that. Wait. Assembly is Finland. I think, yeah. I still need to get to Scandinavia for sure for demo scene.
In kmscon now, obviously.
I mean, it would be nice to make a bosomatic variation into kmscon. Yeah. Your hand was a little bit fast.
Does it support subpixel rendering for rendering the fonts?
Does it support subpixel rendering for the fonts? Yes. Whatever. FreeType does. So it's using FreeType and through Pango.
When you rotate the stream, then it takes into consideration, or then it is broken?
It's rendering. No, it should work.
FreeType doesn't do the rotation. You do the rotation.
I do the rotation. I don't.
It's broken, maybe.
That's good. That I need to look, but I think. It's not broken, but I need to look into that. That's good. Thanks a lot. Yeah.
Maybe I missed the presentation, but is there any minimum version of OpenGL required?
A minimum version of OpenGL required, I think? I would guess, oh my god, 3.3? I mean, even OpenGL 4 point something is like 10 or I don't know how many years old, but certainly any system should work, but I think 3.3 should be enough. Yeah.
How does this compare to using a full-screen real-time compositor, such as Cage, compared with a lightweight terminal emulator?
How does it compare to a lightweight compositor? That's a good question. I have no idea. I think it's more lightweight. It's simpler. It's certainly not a desktop environment, so it's nothing like Western. You can at some point easily make the jump to that if you keep pushing, but no, it's not. It's just one OpenGL context. You render your terminal screen into that, and that's it. There you go.
Yeah, thank you. So two questions. First, regarding the mouse. Do you implement all the mouse handling by yourself, or it can be integrated into the editor? So, for example, some of console editors handle mouse events.
No, it's right now in process of kmscon. It's the question is if the mouse handling could be, for example, handled or actually be read in an editor like Emacs, I guess, or Vim or something. No, it's not like it's a kmscon version of GPM. That would be the next step. But that would be a nice patch.
Okay. And second question, if you allow. So you are handling all the rotation inside your GL. Have you thought about handling rotation for the KMS properties?
Suggestion how to handle the rotation through KMS properties. I haven't considered that. I can look into that and then see if that makes sense or if I can do it or change my patch. Sure. Yeah, okay. Anything else? Well, if. Yeah.